Hi guys, this is Miss Emily at Upstage Dance Center. I'm here with Emily, and she is going to be my model for our straight low ponytail today. So we've already started out, and I've straightened her hair in the back, so all of this section back here is already straightened. It's good to go, but I am just going to finish straightening the sides so that you guys can see. So I'm just taking a brush, making sure that her hair is nice and brushed out before I actually do this. So if we try to straighten hair that's not smooth, it's going to be a lot more difficult. So just running my straightener down through it, and then I'm going to go back with a brush and kind of catch it, and then just re-go over it again. So she does have naturally wavy hair, and if you have a child that has more wavy hair than her, it's a good idea to, as you're straightening, to pull your straightener to the side so that it's almost creating like a curl under, so that if you have any extra hairs that are shorter and they want to poke out, they'll kind of naturally want to curve in instead. So doing the same thing, just brushing this out, and then I am splitting this into smaller sections. So I'm going to do the top section up here, and then I'll do the one underneath. And again, just kind of brushing through it with my fingers to make sure that it's still nice and smooth. And I'm grabbing my brush, I'm gonna catch that hair before it falls and go back through and re-go over it. And then once that's done, you can just push it out of the way. And then we'll do that last bottom section over here. If it's getting in the way, you can always try to flip it to the other side and it'll stay out of the way that way as well. Catching that hair, brushing through it again to make sure it stays nice and straight. It's not getting all curled up underneath, getting tangledy. All right, and then we're good with this side. So I'm gonna move over to the other side of her hair. I'm just gonna brush this through once to make sure that everything is still good. And coming over here, brush through. Start on the top. And I'm just moving that through pretty slowly. I'm not just pulling it straight through. You have to leave it on there for a second so that it can actually do its job and straighten the hair. If you go too fast, it's not going to actually do anything because the heat doesn't stay on the hair for long enough to change the texture of the hair. So make sure you're not leaving it on for too long. If you start to see smoke because you're staying in one place, that's not a good thing. If you're moving it through the hair and you see smoke, that's okay. That's just what happens when things get hot. So it's the same thing with our hair. We just don't want to leave it on there for too long and then let the hair crisp and fall off. I've seen movies before where somebody was curling their hair and they left the curling iron in for too long and a piece of hair fell off. So we don't want that to happen. But as long as you're moving it through and you're not just staying in one place, you're giving it enough time to straighten the hair, but you're not just sitting on the hair long. It's not gonna do anything. It's not gonna damage the hair. And then we just got a couple more little sections that we're gonna do. Catching that section with the brush after I'm done with it, and then coming back through again. And then same thing as last time, I'm just gonna flip this hair to the other side so that it's not hanging down in the way. And our last section. It's important for your child to be able to provide a little bit of resistance. So if she was just letting her head go and falling over every time I pulled on her hair, then it's not gonna really do as good a job as it will if she's actually keeping her head held straight so that the straightener can pull and do its job. All right, so she does have this little section of hair right here that's pretty wavy toward the root. So I am going to just get a little bit closer to her scalp. Now I'm gonna be really careful that I'm not touching her scalp with a straightener because I don't wanna hurt her. So if you want to take a comb or something like this, you can hold it up against the scalp so that the straightener isn't gonna touch it. If you aren't confident in doing that, you just wanna get really close so that you can see how much space you're still leaving between the hair and the scalp. So I got close enough that we got those hairs, but I didn't get so close that we're burning her. And tell your child too that it's really important, and they might be scared because they feel the heat from the straightener or the curling iron if you're doing something curly. Tell them it's really important that they try to sit still and not flinch, because as soon as they flinch, it's gonna make a more dangerous potentially situation for them. Okay, so they have to trust that you're gonna do your job and be really steady and not hurt them. All right, so we are doing the left part for her straight pony. So I'm just gonna go right above her left eyebrow. So her left eyebrow right here, I'm gonna go right above that, and then I'm taking this rat tail comb, and I'm just gonna go straight back from that point. So getting in front of her and making sure that I'm going straight back, and I'm creating this two sections of hair. One of them's gonna go down, the other one's gonna pull over. Now, I'm gonna go to the other side and check this because I'm standing kind of off to the side. It's hard to tell if it's going straight back. So I'm gonna come over here and just kind of make a little adjustment to that part to make sure that it's still doing what I want it to do. All right. And then once you've got the hair on the sides that you want it, again, just run a brush through it. And then as we are brushing her hair, you guys can probably see that there's a little bit of static. So we actually have a product that's gonna kind of sleek all that down and make sure that it's not kind of sticking out and flying away, okay? And we have the Garnier Fructis, it's called Smoothing Milk. So we're gonna use that here in a little bit. We're not gonna use it yet, but we're gonna use that eventually. We are using the Garnier Fructis Styling Gel for the front of her hair. So I'm just putting this on my hands, and then I'm just gonna really lightly brush this through her hair. So I don't wanna just put a big clump on my hands and then just kind of stick it on her hair. I'm gonna kind of put it on my fingertips and just lightly brush those little baby hairs. And I'm gonna do the same thing to the top. So the top where those hairs by the part want to stick up, I'm just kind of lightly brushing those down with my hand, and that gel is gonna help hold them down so that they're not flying away. And then the same thing over here. Just using this on the fingertips to really brush these front little baby hairs down. And then as we go through, we'll be able to fine tune it just a little bit more. Okay. So once we've got our gel in, that's kind of like a pre-style tool. So we're not gonna put that in as we're going through the style, but we wanna make sure that that's in before we even start to smooth the stuff back. And we're just making sure her hair is ready to go, essentially. So once that's in, I'm gonna wipe my hands off. And then I'm going to start her ponytail. So her hair is already mostly brushed back. So I'm just gonna go in with this is just still a normal brush, and I'm brushing her hair back into that ponytail shape. And I'm just kind of holding it with my other hand. And then once we've got it all where we want it to go, we're then gonna go back with the smoothing brush to make sure that everything is nice and tight and we don't have any flyaways, we don't have any hair sticking out. So I've got it all in my hand back here. And now I'm gonna use this bristle brush, and this should be on the sheet of makeup and of hair tools that you received. This is a boar bristle brush, and it's just really dense, it's really thick, and it's gonna do a really good job at smoothing all her hair out. So again, I have that gel in there already. And then as I go, You can see that some of these little hairs are starting to poke out. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put a light coat of hairspray on as I'm working. And I'm not spraying this from the side because then it's gonna get on her face. And since her makeup's already done, we don't want to ruin any of that. So I'm gonna actually spray it from the front. Then I'm gonna kind of get out of the way. And I'm gonna just hit those little edges right there so that we can then work that hairspray in and get those hairs to stay down. So I've got those down. And then I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side too. So I'm coming in with my hairspray. And then I'm also gonna spray the top on this side since the majority of her hair is over here. And then just spraying that, spraying the sides. And then just smoothing it all down. Okay, so if you go ahead and have that ponytail holder on your wrist as you're holding the ponytail, then you can just pull it off. Okay, so I'm gonna let go real quick. So it's already on this left wrist, and since I'm holding the ponytail like this, I can just pull it over my hand and immediately start to wrap the hair. So I'm gonna put it there, I'm gonna get her hair together, and then again, I'm just gonna go back through with that smoothing brush and get anything that's kind of flying away, down and out. So smoothing everything down. And once we're there, we wanna make sure that it's really tight. So you might have to readjust your hand a little bit and then kind of readjust, maybe brush a couple more times, but it is something that you're gonna have to work with. So you can't just immediately brush the hair back and expect to pull the ponytail holder onto the ponytail and it be good to go. You kind of have to do some little readjustments and make sure that things are still where they're supposed to be. So it's still really tight in your hand and it's still really smooth. So I'm just kind of making those adjustments back here. And respraying as I go so that hairspray really holds the hair and is not letting things go places where we don't want it to go. So again, just make sure that it's really tight. And once we've got everything smoothed out and really nice and good, then we're gonna just pull that ponytail holder off our hand and onto the ponytail. So, we're good. And make sure that it's centered in their head. So you really wanna use the ears to gauge. So if you stand directly behind them and use the ears to kind of gauge where is the middle, that way they're not gonna end up with a ponytail over here on the side, but it'll be right in the middle where it's supposed to be. And the placement of the ponytail, I'm putting all the way down by her hairline. So it's not going in the middle of her head. I'm not pulling it up at all. It's all the way down by her hairline, and I'll have her turn her head to the side here in a second. I'm wrapping this as many times as I possibly can. And then just brushing through the ends of it with my fingers. So once we've got that done, I'm gonna take the hairspray one more time, and I'm just gonna put a coat on, and then I'm, again, just running my hand over things to make sure that those hairs are smoothed down and that they're not sticking out. So again, up here at the front, she does have a few of those little flyaways still, those little baby hairs. So I'm just gonna take a tiny, tiny bit of gel and just push those down, slick them back so she has a nice clean edge. She doesn't have any hair poking out. If you do see hairs poking out randomly, you can just take a little extra bit of gel and smooth them down. It's always a good idea to check your ponytail from the side as well to make sure that it's not just kind of a one view thing. You looked at it one way and it looked good, but then maybe you didn't see it from another angle and it doesn't look quite as good. So we can see the top of her hair. We can still see the part there. So take your head down just a little bit for me. So we can still see her part. When I pulled her hair back, I was really careful to not brush it straight back and erase that part, essentially. And then, will you look to the right for me a little bit? So if we look to the right, we can see that that's coming down. Look as far to the right as you can. And then we can see that ponytail is all the way down at the base of her hairline right there. So we want this all to be smooth on the way back. And then again, if you have any hairs, like there's a couple right here, we're just gonna spray those real quick and use our hand to brush them out and smooth them out. And then on the ponytail itself, I am gonna take a little bit of that smoothing milk, and I'm just gonna put a tiny, tiny bit in my hand. Tiny, tiny bit. And I'm gonna use that on the ponytail to make sure that we don't have any hairs that get staticky and start to kind of stick out. But we're just running that through. I'm just kind of massaging it through her hair. And I'm using my fingers to break it up a little bit too, so that it doesn't just get a coat on the outside, but it's getting in the middle of that ponytail as well. All right, and once we've got that, here's her ponytail, nice and straight. And to the back, it is right in the middle. Okay, back to the front for me. And that's it. So if you have any questions or comments, or if you need any help with anything, just let us know down in the comment section and we'll try to get back with you and let you know what you can do and how you can fix some things. And I hope this video has been helpful and that it assists you in your students' hairstyle. So thanks for watching and we'll see you later.